Rewire Your Mindset, Own Your Thinking, Control Your Actions, Change Your Life, written and read by Brian Keane.
Prologue. Anne Lamott once observed that all writers are little rivers running into one lake, all contributing to the same big project. I consider myself immensely fortunate to have been influenced by so many incredible people over the years, and without the ideas, philosophies, and teachings of the people whose lives have interwoven with mine, this book would never have come to pass. Any acknowledgement, praise, or applause for the writing should not be directed to me, but to those who have had a positive impact on me over the years. Even the negative people I have encountered deserve equal appreciation, as every person with whom I have ever come in contact has molded my personality, character, and sense of self over the years. Truth be told, as you will see from listening to Rewire Your Mindset, owning the fire from negative people may have an even greater impact on your life than the influence of positive people. Nothing is inherently good or bad, but your perception of it renders it so, and the negativity you encounter can be the fuel to keep you going when times get difficult. On the days when you're tired or don't feel like making an effort, you can use those words as the motivation to get you up and pursuing your dream or goal. When you learn to rewire the way you interpret things by taking responsibility for everything in your life and combining the positive influences with negative fuel, I hope you'll see that you can become virtually unstoppable in your endeavors. For years, the stories I told myself, my negative self-talk, and my unsupportive mind chatter would lead me down a road of self-sabotage, fear, and anxiety. Only when I learned to completely own the way I chose to see things was I able to control any change in my life. My mantra, own it, control it, change it, that you'll come across throughout this book was my way of overcoming fear and self-sabotage. For years, I made too many decisions out of fear and worry about the opinions of others. There is nothing special about me. The only difference between us is that I may be a couple of steps ahead of you in my way of thinking. What I do know, though, is that smart people learn from their mistakes, and the smarter ones learn from the mistakes of others. I've woven personal stories from my life into this book to help contextualize some of the ideas presented. But I hope that the book serves as a catalyst for building a stronger mindset and fostering the understanding that nothing in your life, your body, your relationships, your job, is going to change until you start making new decisions or seeing things in different ways. The truth is, there is no such thing as a new idea, and probably there hasn't been an original thought in thousands of years. But I've tried to bring to you some of the ideas that have greatly supported my own life and transformed me from being a victim who blamed the world for all my problems into a stronger version of myself who owned and changed my life. This mindset of mine has led to some external successes, from building an incredibly profitable international fitness business and becoming a best-selling author, to running 6 back-to-back marathons through the Sahara Desert and surviving a grueling 230-kilometer run through the Arctic. Over the years, I've traveled the world as a professional fitness expert, competed in multiple bodybuilding shows, and run multiple marathons and ultramarathons, but it's the inward success I achieved that I truly value. I would never have been able to achieve any outward success if I wasn't inwardly in control of what I thought, did, or said, and I had to learn to do all of that. The aim of this book is to help you attain inward success by controlling the way you see situations, conditioning yourself to feel fear and do the things you fear anyway, learning how to avoid self-sabotage, and applying strategies such as creating the right habits and using the full power of the compound effect to secure your goals. It's this inward success that leads us to any subjective outward achievement, and the principles in this book go through it all. I wasn't born with any of these capabilities, and had to develop them through struggle, sacrifice, and self-awareness. Although your goals may be completely different from mine, I hope this book serves as a blueprint for ceasing being a victim and taking responsibility for everything that happens to you. As I'll discuss in later chapters, success is relative. You might be looking to build enough confidence to finally talk to that person you fancy, or eliminate self-sabotage when it comes to your eating and training so that you can look the way you want to look. You might even be trying to rewire your mindset so that you feel fear and do the things you're afraid of anyway. Different sections of the book will resonate with you in different ways. The key is to not stop at listening. Once something resonates with you, be sure to make a note of it and follow it up with the action steps that take you closer to your end goal, whatever that is. My hope for this book is that you exactly get what you need.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.